as the availability of fossil fuels starts to decline, it'll probably be possible, theoretically, for us to continue supporting the number of people we have if we're very careful and very intelligent in how we grow food. We're going to have to relocalize food production. We're going to have to use very labor-intensive and intelligent means of growing food, systems like permaculture and biointensive gardening. But if we don't do that, if we don't act proactively to break up the huge industrial farms and teach people how to grow their own food and start encouraging urban gardening and things like that, the result is going to be massive starvation, because we simply won't be able to support the population that we have now without fossil fuels. So this means basically a reversal of the trend that existed throughout the 20th century. During the 20th century, the trend was urbanization. People were moving off of farms into cities because they couldn't compete with the fuel-fed farm machinery. Now, in the 21st century, we're going to have to move people out of cities and back onto farms. It's going to be a trend of re-ruralization. If we don't do that, there's simply no way that a few million people working on the farm are going to be able to support enormous numbers of people living in cities. There won't be any way to transport the food to them. So this is probably the greatest demographic challenge the human race has ever faced. As oil production peaks, we'll see economies begin to come apart at the seams. Nations may begin to fight over the world's remaining oil supplies. We'll see increasing competition between oil importing nations. We'll also see increasing unrest within oil nations as different social factions vie for control of this increasingly valuable resource. We'll see farmers going bankrupt as they are unable to pay for fuel for their tractors. As a result of that, food prices will skyrocket, and we'll see increasing levels of hunger. As economies collapse, then people will begin to default on their loans and mortgages. We'll see enormous increase in homelessness. In other words, we're talking about a situation somewhat similar to the Great Depression of the 1930s, only in this case probably far worse, because during the 1930s, most people still lived rurally. Most people still produced at least some of their own necessities. Now, today, we're so much more dependent on stores, long-distance transportation, large-scale manufacturing, that as this system begins to fail, we'll have very little else to rely on. Looking at the colliding effects of peak oil and global climate change, it would seem that we are facing something like a collapse of industrial civilization. Of course, it wouldn't be the first time that human civilization has collapsed. There have been something like 24 civilizations in the past, and most of them have come apart because of resource depletion or habitat destruction. In our case, it's likely to be much worse because, of course, what we have today is a global civilization. When's it going to happen? I think a good rough estimate would be sometime around the middle decades of this century. Humans like to pride ourselves on our intelligence, and of course, you know, here we are able to make computers and video cameras and all kinds of complex technologies. Wonderful stuff. But really, nature only cares about one kind of intelligence, and that's the intelligence that would enable us to look at what we're doing and the likely consequences of our actions, to be able to judge which consequences are detrimental to our own survival prospects, and then change our behavior accordingly. If we can do that, then I think nature will judge us as being an intelligent species. If we can't, then I don't think we have right to think of ourselves as being any more intelligent than yeast. which would be acting exactly the same way. If we put them in a bottle of grape juice, they'd be eating up the sugar in the grape juice, consuming their energy source, and at the same time they'd be giving off a waste product, namely alcohol, and which would be poisoning them. And so their numbers would proliferate until they ate up their energy sources and poisoned themselves with their waste product, and then they'd have a die-off. We're doing exactly the same thing with fossil fuels. We're eating up our energy source as fast as we can, and we're polluting the environment with the waste product. So are we smarter than yeast? That's the question. We'll find out.
Can you play the violin so I can sing the story of my ancestors?